Hello everyone, this video will give a brief introduction about software testing. So what we are going to see is why software testing is required, and it is because the quality or acceptability of a system in case of a software can be judged by testing the software, and also the problems can be discovered, since we as human beings know that we are fallible. The video further will give a perspective on software testing. So this slide specifies the levels of abstraction in waterfall model of SDLC, that is software development lifecycle. This is very much helpful in identifying distinct levels of testing and identifying objectives of testing at each level. The diagram emphasizes the correspondence between software testing and design levels. Three levels of definitions corresponds to the three levels of testing, that is requirement specification map to system testing, the preliminary design corresponds to integration testing, detailed design corresponds to unit testing. So there is a relationship between levels of testing with the functional and structural testing, and it is proven that software structural testing is appropriate at unit level, since constructs defined for structural testing make most sense at unit level. This is a unit level, so it makes more sense at unit level, while functional testing is most appropriate for system level. This figure portrays life cycle model for testing. So this is a testing life cycle. So in the development phase, there are three opportunities in which errors are made, and these faults propagate through the remainder of the development process. That is, in the requirement specification, if any error happens, then that same error will be propagated to design phase, since those erroneous requirements will be used in the designing, and that erroneous design will be used for coding. Thus, the error in the requirements will propagate as a fault to the coding phase. So first three phases will seed bugs in, and the last three phases are getting the bugs out. The testing phase will find the bugs. Now, fault resolution is one step that will resolve the error and also another opportunity for new faults. And this is because of a bad fix. That is, a fix will result in a correct software to misbehave. Thus, it is clear that test cases occupy central position in testing, and focus is therefore to identify useful test cases. Now, this slide gives an overview of the contents a test case should have. The essence of software testing is to determine set of test cases for the item under test. A clarification is required on what has to be tested. So a test case will have the first thing, which is test case ID, that is unique for each test case, then the purpose or what condition that is being tested, then precondition, input, expected output, post condition, and this is the execution history, which will be which will give the date, result of the test case, execution version under test, and who executed the test case. Now, coming in detail to test case, a test case will have the following data, that is, inputs are of two types. One is precondition, and this is actual input. Precondition is nothing but the circumstances that should be prior to test case execution. That is, when we take an ATM system, the condition that has to exist initially is a welcome screen. Then it will prompt to insert the ATM. So that is the precondition. Now actual input is inserting the ATM. Then expected output again is of two types, that is post condition and actual output. So post condition for the test case will be once the ATM is inserted, then either it should give the post condition stating that enter the PIN, or if the ATM is not inserted properly, it should tell, is the ATM inserted properly or not. So that is the first condition. And actual output. Actual output is the output that we obtained. So the act of testing entails establishing necessary precondition, providing necessary test case input, observing output, comparing the obtained output with expected output to determine if the test case is passed or not. So if the expected output is the same as actual output, then the test case will be passed. So this is all about the brief introduction on testing. Thank you.